So do you know the company behind this game? Yes, exactly. So that's what we are going to do today. Exploring the world of Tencent games. So here's the contents. My friend Sam will take over.
The contents are Tencent, Tencent Games, statistics, competitors, strategies, some popular games, why Tencent Games are so successful, challenges, and finally the conclusion. So Tencent, before we start talking about Tencent Games, first we need to talk about the parent company of the Tencent Games, which is Tencent Holding Limited. Did you guys know that Tencent was the first company to reach $500 billion mark from the Asia? It was the first company to join the likes of Apple and Facebook to reach that mark. So now we start. It was started in 1998 in Shenzhen, China. The co-founder was Ma Huateng, commonly known as Pony Ma. The total revenue for the financial year 2018 was 3,16,698 crores, and the profit for the year 2018 was 81,088 crore. The services offered by Tencent are social network, payments, entertainment, utilities, platform, and artificial intelligence.
So now, coming back to the topic, we should know about Tencent Game, what exactly it is. So it was first started in 2003, and it is one of the biggest gaming services company in terms of its revenues. In 2004, it first launched, the first game was launched, that the name is QQ Tang. And after that, in 2007, it launched another game, and it reached the maximum number of users in that game in the year 2007. After which, in 2011, Tencent also started hosting massive big online multiplayer events to engage various kinds of audiences throughout all the world to engage each and everyone in real time basis. And then we can see that the total count of games that were published by Tencent were 16, and the games that were developed were around 8. And now we can see the statistics over here, which shows the past 8 years of growth of Tencent games over here. As we can see, it started from 9,631 crores, and it went up to 1,05,331 crores. That was a very big success for Tencent games. No other company could achieve this in such a short period of time.
So now we'll go on to the competitive analysis of the Tencent games. As we can see from the chart, there Tencent games is the market leader in terms of gaming revenue generated by every company. The main thing of Tencent games is that the games they bring are from mobile, and mobile is now found to everyone. So bringing games on mobile expands the market size of the company. Sony, Microsoft, they ply their trades in console gaming, so that's why their revenue is a little bit smaller, because console gaming is something which is very expensive. You know, PlayStation 4 comes at rupees 40,000. So when it comes to Apple and Google, Apple and Google compete in the terms of Apple Play Store, Google Play Store, and Apple App Store. So the games that they, the services, the price they charge for that services accrue the revenue for them. The Activision Blizzard is also a gaming company like Tencent. They also produce games. The famous games of Activision Blizzard are Call of Duty. You may all know Call of Duty. NetEase, E8, and Nintendo also are gaming companies. EA, you must know the market share of EA is very low. You must be wondering why. Because EA has lagged behind Tencent and Sony, because EA has stopped producing games, and the games that they focus are more on acquiring money rather than serving the clients. So EA is very far behind.
So now, as my friend have mentioned you all the competitors over here, the major competitors, we also must know about the market share that they hold. So as we can see over here, Tencent has 18% of the market share out of 100. Just can you believe that, guys? 18% is a very huge amount. After that, only Sony, Microsoft are the ones who can come a bit nearer to Tencent games. Otherwise, all are then 6%, 5%, 4%. So we can just see how big this company is with 18% of 7,93,212 crores. So now let's move on to the strategies the Tencent Games have been applying. So the first one is Tencent Games have been working very hard to engage with various audiences with their online presence. As you know, Tencent is a very big company and it holds various kinds of platforms like social media messages and networking apps. So the major app that they had was WeChat QQ, through which they started marketing about the games and publishing it all around the world.
By the way, going about that, WeChat has a total population of 1.1 billion. So anything that goes on to marketing of WeChat goes through many customers. So marketing on WeChat is very beneficial. So next, moving its popular PC titles to mobile platform. This means that some games are made for computer only. So when games are made on computer, the hardcore gamers, they play that game over there and they start playing it, and then they get they love that game. So when you bring that game into mobile platform, the user base of that increases drastically. So it becomes an instant success.
Now, as we can see, esports, there are various kinds of events that are held all over the world, like India Finals, Premier League, or all various kind of events which engage all audiences all around the world, so that they can compete in real time and they can engage in various interactive sessions also.
The next is partnership with other companies to form domination. The main USP of Tencent is that they form strategic alliances with other companies, so that you must have heard of the statement that if you can't compete, buy them. So Tencent is very excellent in this form of strategy. They have 40% share in Riot Games, which is the main owner of Fortnite. You must have all have heard about Fortnite. It's a very famous game. It generates $3 billion in revenue. So this is a form of strategy that they apply in partnership. Also, they have a 5% share in Ubisoft, 5% share in Activision Blizzard. So these are their competitors, but still they have share in that company. So you must have got the idea that it's about their strategy.
And also there are various customer engagement programs that they use, like they try to deliver each and every customer individually by creating personalized effects or knowledge to share with the customers, so that they can really know what is there in the game and how do they understand about it better.
Now we come about serious. Serious is a very important topic. Serious gaming is considered that gaming which inculcates some sort of learning into the minds of the gamers. So that seriousness requires, once Ubisoft launched the game, its name was Dig Rush. So that game was for the, there were eye patients, they used to play that game, and 90% of them showed increase in the recovery. So it's another strategy that Tencent follows. Next.
So now let's know about some popular games that Tencent had over the years. The main difference is that Tencent, as it is a very huge company, the main difference is published and developed. Published are the games that were the Tencent games were the investor in those games, and developed were the Tencent games had particularly owned and developed it by themselves. So these are a few lists. PUBG Mobile was the one of the biggest games that Tencent did and developed. You can see all the list over here also. Naruto and Mobile and all were famous. Now let's know the reason behind the huge success of Tencent Games. Taking a case study of PUBG Mobiles, PUBG, we can play it in real time, we can engage with our friends and do voice chat, we can also strategize to hit targets, and we can create a lot of environments and scenarios. We can also, the main thing now, surviving in a round means that you have won over other 99 people who are there in the game. And then there are daily login rewards and cashback. There is Royal Pass where you can get every day different events and all.
Now coming on to the challenges, first is the user engagement. User engagement is that in the market of Tencent games, the barrier of entry is very low because the games are free of cost. So since the games are free of cost, it's easy to enter the market. And since it is easy to enter the market, it's that much easy to leave the market. So it's a challenge for Tencent to retain its customers. Second is mobile monetization. Mobile monetization means how to monetize the games that are played in the mobile. Since mobile players play very less amount of time, it is very difficult to monetize them, since we play only 15 to 20 minutes. Third is game portfolio. The main idea of Tencent Games is to earn through game portfolio. So if one of the games fail, then they have to reconsider its strategy. One game in China, for example, PUBG failed in China because they failed to acquire two licenses. they failed to acquire two licenses. So when